الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله مبارك على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. I also wanted to thank Professor Ali Sheikh and the team of DAT for organizing this very important conference. And I hope this will be the beginning of a new era for holding international conferences shared by our Turkish brothers, academicians and politicians, and the Somali politicians, business people and academicians to discuss common interest areas. My presentation will be very brief, 10 to 15 minutes. I will talk historically, Somali-Turkish relations past and present. So I will start with what I call enabling factors of Somali-Turkic relations. What are the enabling factors that Turkey and Somalia are bounded to have in a strategic partnership? The first factor is both countries are frontier Muslim states. Frontier Muslim states means that they are located in the front line of Islam and non-Muslims, Muslims and non-Muslims. This condition causes that national identity of Islam and Islam are intertwined and inseparable. So you mean that Somaliness and Turkishness made it synonymous to Muslim. You are a Muslim when you are Somali, when you are Turk. This is the shared factor. The second point that is enabling factor is global geostrategic importance. Both countries are located in a very strategic and vital strategic locations with huge challenges and opportunities. Third element is transport and ethnic extension. Somalia borders Djibouti, Kenya, and Ethiopia, in which 50% of the Somali ethnic population live as citizens of these countries. On the other hand, Turkey have also transported ethnic extension to Caucasus and Central Asian states of Turkic ethnic linguistic zone, such as Azerbaijan, Kazakhstan, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan. Fourth, Somalia has a huge, both countries have huge diaspora communities. 6 million Turkish and more than 2 million Somalis live in all continents. Even though Somali diaspora are very, very new, they are very active politically and produced first Muslim woman in hijab in US Congress and a minister in Canada. Fifth, entrepreneurship in business. Somalis and Turkey business people have demonstrated to be risk takers in business venture. For example, it's normal to see a Somali shopkeeper in faraway village in South Africa carry with him the Quran and building a small prayer site. This is the two strategic locations of Somalia and Turkey, and then we'll talk about it further. But what is the foundation of that relation between Turkey and Somalia? Islam is the foundation of Turkish-Somali relations. We must put in mind, it's not just two countries. It's they have the common faith and common religion. And the Somalis, the first Muslim migration that when Somalis become Muslim, when the Muslim minority in Mecca, the first hijrah to Abyssinia. That was the beginning of Islam in the Horn of Africa. Then Islam took roots in two cities in Somalia, that Zeyla and Mogadishu. According to historic records, Islamization of Mogadishu may take may taken place during the caliphate of Omar ibn al-Khattab, meaning the first half of 17th century AD. However, total Islamization of Somalia took place in the 13th and 14th century. For example, Somali Islamic scholar and explorer from Mogadishu called Imam Sa'id al-Mogadishawi traveled to China in the 14th century during the Yang dynasty and met Ibn Battuta in the west coast of India. And he gave information to Ibn Battuta, which is recorded in a Battuta well-known book. Somalis, being part of Muslim Ummah, always offered allegiance to the Muslim caliphates, and the last one was an Ottoman caliphate. Now we move to the strategic locations for both countries. Somalia is undergoing a post-transition recovery period. It is situated in the strategic Horn of Africa, which has long attracted competing global powers. Somali coastline, about 3,025 kilometers, is the longest in the mainland Africa and the Middle East. Through its territorial waters passes 33,000 commercial ships every year. This ship is carried 26% of global oil trade and 14 to 15% of the international trade, with a cost of almost 2 trillion annually. Challenges of Somali strategic locations. The strategic geographical location of Somalia is both an asset and a liability. It attracted multiple colonial and Cold War superpower rivals. Barisa has flourished along the Somali coast. Terrorism has gained a foothold in the largest swathes of Somalia, threatening the whole region of the Greater Horn of Africa. This situation has prompted the presence of international naval forces in the Somali territorial waters and African Union forces, AMISOM, in the inland to fight piracy and terrorist insurgency of Shabab, respectively. Opportunities. Against all these impediments, the Somali people have remained resilient, responding to the challenges with inventiveness and endurance, and creating a robust private sector in the last two decades. The Somali private sector has been growing, especially trade, transport, remittance services, and telecommunications. Somalia's abundant reserves in natural resources such as oil, natural gas, mineral deposits remain untapped. And it is long coast along the Indian Ocean with bountiful marine resources is yet to be exploited. Somalia's economy is recovering from destroyed physical, human, and social capital during the civil war. Moreover, conducive environment for reconstructing Somalia has now been laid down, and political and legal framework has been established. Strategic position of Turkey. Turkey is a rising regional power strategically at the crossroads of Europe, Asia, connecting east and west. It borders 8 countries and 4 seas, controls the Strait of Bosphorus and Dardanelles. The nexus of that bridge is between the rich natural resources of the Caspian Basin in Central Asia and Western world. The rise to power of AK Party in 2002 offered impetus to Turkey growing soft power, directed primarily at those countries and the historical role of Ottoman Empire in the Middle East and the Caucasus and Africa. Turkey has the largest military in Europe and it is second largest in NATO. Turkey economy is strong and it's 16th largest economy in the world and 7th in Europe, a fact that propelled its inclusion in G20. Turkey has also become a prominent humanitarian power, contributing more than 1 billion in aid in 2012. This makes the 4th largest government donor behind the only US and EU and UK. Turkey vastly increased its role in world affairs, giving priority to trade and humanitarian intervention. In particular, Turkey has invigorated its cultural roots an historical connection with the countries previously ruled by the Ottoman Empire. The impetus of Turkey-Somali relations. Turkey's interest in bolstering relations with Somalia has culminated in the historic visit of Turkish Prime Minister of that time, President Erdogan, in 2011, at the height of famine that killed about 260,000 people. Somali people highly welcome it and express gratitude to brother Turkish intervention and consider it a reliable partner, being a Muslim and democratic state. Somali jumped rapidly into the top three states receiving Turkish assistance globally and greatest beneficiary in Africa. Thus, Turkey has been gaining enormous influence in Somalia due to its humanitarian intervention coupled with multi-sector cooperation in education, healthcare, business, and reconciliation. Early history of Somali-Turkish relations. The first Turkish-Somali contact has been traced back to the Ottoman rule of Sultan Salim I in 1517, after the Ottoman Empire expanded it into Egypt and Red Sea. Ottomans then came to Somalia, the Horn of Africa, Cape of Guardafu, in the current Puntland state of Somalia. The very Turkish involvement in the Horn of Africa occurred during the Muslim-Christian Bush-Bull War in the 16th century. Ottomans has provided Imam Ahmed Gurey in his struggle against Highlanders, Christian Highlanders in Ethiopia, about 700 troops and weapons. So I'm moving fast because of. This is the map of Turkey expansion to the Horn of Africa. This is the mosque built by Zeyda during the Ottoman rule. Early history of Somali-Turkish relations continue. In the 16th century, there was an Ajuran Sultanate in Somalia that has ruled Somalia for 300 years. That during that time, there was Portugal and Ottoman Empire, the two superpowers, and the war in the Horn of Africa between the Christians and Muslims. Turkish government has sided with the Muslim Somalis to fight against the Portuguese rule that has been trying to capture Mogadishu and Prawa. Then both of them, they have allied forces to protect Indian Ocean, and then that cooperation reached its peak in 1580 during the Mir Ali Bey command of Turkish fleet in Indian Ocean. With Somali, Turkish military expedition was sent as far as to South Asia. I'm concluding very fast. Contemporary history of Somali-Turkish relations are well known, and you have talked about, and I will not talk about it. It's pressuring me, so I will not talk about it. So I will move into to conclude. Here comes then the manifestations of Turkish-Somali relations. That security sector. This is the military training base, and this is the humanitarian sector with the visit of former Prime Minister of Turkey in Mogadishu, 2011. This in the health sector, the biggest hospital in Mogadishu, that's called an Erdogan hospital. This is the airport of Mogadishu, built by Turkish. And this is the seaport. This is the seaport, Mogadishu, operated by a Turkish company. And then here comes then, the last one is that the Turkish role in reconciliation, where they have brought the president of Somalia and the president of breakaway Somaliland to try to reconcile them. Thank you very much.